Let's try that again. Madison, are you still there?
Yes.
Oh, I'm awake. I had a dream just now. I saw. You did? Wow. I really thought I was back home. Oh, the sun back in my homeworld isn't a light bulb. It's a big ball of fire in the sky. I don't think I'd be able to hold it like I do with the sun from your world.
This isn't my world.
Huh? This isn't the world I live in.
Really?
I guess not. If you're the god of this world, you wouldn't necessarily be in it. What's your homeworld called?
Earth.
Earth? Like the stuff on the ground? Wait, do you live underground?
No.
Oh, neither do we. But shrews and field mice and stuff do. Does your world have a sun?
Yes, it's also a ball of fire.
Really? Wow! Can you hold it? That was a silly question, wasn't it? The sun in my homeworld is very bright. Warm, too. You saw, right? But it goes away sometimes, at night. Everything gets dark, kind of like how this world is now. That's okay, because the sun always comes back the next day. That's good, don't you think?
My world is like that, too.
Oh, do you sleep during the night?
We go to sleep, usually. But some people stay up and use computers.
I don't have to explain what they are, do I? There's a bunch of them in this world. Anyway, we should probably get going. Oh, this is Amber from the Glen. I can remember now. Activating tracking system. Setting course. Wait, this boat is over capacity. You'll need to leave behind some of your possessions. Oh, well, I don't think I'll be needing this crowbar anymore. Or this gas mask and gloves.
That is acceptable. Onwards we go.
Oh, look at that face! Look at Nico!
Okay, thank goodness I switched from monitor capture to game capture. Here's your stop, the Glen.
Thank you.
There should be a village to the north, but that's all I can recall.
Oh, that's good to know.
Farewell. May your mission be a success.
Are you leaving?
Yes. I must return to my station.
You'll be all alone again.
It's okay. I have not been dinged. Welcome to the Glen. Next stop on the journey to what I'm dubbing the lighthouse. Oh, this game is so pretty. Oh, hi there.
I'm catching fireflies for Mommy.
Oh, Britt would love to see this. There's bird people.
There's bird people. Lula? Lula, where did you go? Madison, did you hear that? Lula, It's coming from the southeast of here.
It's a bird, man.
Hey, you there. Have you seen a little girl? She's a little bit shorter than you and... Wait. That's the sun. Are you our savior?
Yeah?
Oh my stars. Sorry for my rudeness.
Huh? It's alright. Are you looking for someone?
My little sister. She's been gone for 3 days now.
Looking all over, but what does she look like?
A little shorter than you. Long blue hair, 2 blue feathers on top of her head.
I'm sorry, I haven't seen anyone like that. Where was the last place you saw her?
Back inside the ruins. She said she was headed towards the forest, so I'm waiting here now. I don't know if places to look. Oh, poor bird man.
The ruins is over here.
Oh, there's Chandler.
Son, you're the Messiah. Are you on your way to the tower?
Mm-hmm.
You can enter the refuge through this wall. You'll need to sign your name in this scroll first.
Alright. Do you have a pen?
No, I've lost mine. Perhaps you should look around the glen for another. Yeah, the ruins is over here. Hello, person. Please do note that the ruins below are partially flooded.
Oh, should we not be here?
There is no immediate danger. Using this area as a dwelling is not recommended, however. Oh, another computer. Oh my goodness. Let me just switch to monitor capture quick to show you what happened. Change the wallpaper. Thanks. I mean, why though? Why? Hello again, Addison. It seems I need to help you again. Nico will not be able to progress otherwise. This time, the information you need has fallen to the most easily accessible place on your machine. Do you see it?
Yeah, I do.
Kinda hard not to. I know what to do with it then. Thanks. Because you can just send me an image file. Thanks. Hello, person. 2 children reside near here. The pathway is blocked. My box. These pines appeared mere minutes ago.
Really? I haven't seen a lot of them in doorways and stuff. I just assumed it was because this place was abandoned.
A sign of distress.
Huh?
A living being is near. Of help, but I cannot trace the source.
Oh,
Yeah, here we go.
Savior? I can't believe it. You're real. Miss, are you all right?
No.
We should get you to the village. Maybe they could...
It's okay. It's okay. Too late for me.
But...
the sun. I haven't seen it. I haven't felt it in so long.
Savior, if it's not too much trouble, can you lend me the sun for a while?
Will it make you feel better?
No. It will not save me. I just want to experience the sun one more time before I...
Well...
Would it be too selfish of me to ask? What should I do, Madison?
Give her the sun.
Here! Good, right?
The vine should be gone now.
I'm not afraid anymore. So, we're leaving it with her for now. I'm not afraid anymore. Thank you.
That just made me cry.
Go over here.
One second.
You saved me! Thank you! I was trapped in there for so long! So are you, Alula? You knew my name? Wow! The Messiah really does know everything!
Actually, I just met your brother earlier.
Oh, right. Gosh, Calamus must be so worried. Can you bring me to him?
Wait a minute. How did you know that I was... the Messiah?
I don't have the sun with me.
Your eyes.
Huh? You reminded me of the sun.
Oh, that's why you're our Messiah, right?
Well, a lot of people back in my homeworld have eyes like mine.
Homeworld?
Yeah. I'm actually from another world, you see. A place where the sun is in the sky and not in a tower. You like this world too?
Yeah.
Yay! Calamus keeps saying how this world is getting more dangerous by the minute. That's okay. You're here now. You can make everything better.
Yeah.
Oh, she follows you.
I love this game. There's actually a thing you can do with her in the party while you're
see? All the bugs. Sheep.
Yes, you can herd sheep in this game. What the fuck? Oh my god! Would you like to help me herd my rams? There's a great reward in store for you, I promise. Yeah. Excellent. To the south is a peninsula inhabited by my rams. They are all standing in important spots. You need to move them onto the darker moss. If you get stuck, ring a bell and they'll all return to their original position.
I know that ram! Oh my god.
Good luck. Looks like we gotta herd some rams now, Lula. Can I help? Sure. Hey, Ryan. Ooh, yes, there's bird people. Bird is following me. Okay. I never liked this puzzle. Okay, I messed this one up. You haven't, Ryan? I streamed it, like, a while ago before Christmas. It's a very good game. You need to play it when you get the chance. Spends like half an hour on a stupid ram puzzle. It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia episode. Ryan, oh my god. Get this one. Ryan, Brett, I have to show you this one ram. You provide a great service for all of your kind. In return, take this fine ramble. Oh, thanks. I love this game. Oh my gosh. Okay. Hey, you here to trade? Trade? Yeah. Is there anything you want to get rid of? Make me an offer and I'll give you something in return. You have something like Pat Madison? Yeah, we have the wool. It's kind of useless. I think I have something I'd like to trade. You'll take the wool, right? What can this wool get me? Wool, huh? That'll get you this fine vial of... I'm not sure what this is, actually. Some sort of fabric dye? How about it, Madison?
Wait, Madison, you want to... haggle? Really? Alright then. Madison said they wanted a better offer.
Holy smokes! I forgot I was doing trade with the god for a second there. Okay. In that case, I'll also throw in this commemorative t-shirt. Yes. Glad you're doing business. Hey, Birdman, I found your sister.
Calamus! Alula! You're okay!
Thank goodness.
I was trapped inside this room and it was really scary. But then the Messiah saved me.
Trapped? In the ruins?
Yeah. There was that weird stuff in the door. You know, the floating squares we see next to the ocean sometimes?
Yes, it is birds.
Stuff you told me to stay away from?
What? It's spread to the ruins now? This isn't good.
Don't worry, I didn't touch it. I'm not hurt or anything.
Still, if it gets any worse, we might have to find somewhere else to live.
What is this square stuff exactly?
Bad. Anything that touches them just sorta gets messed up.
Whenever you hear people saying the world is decaying, that's what they meant.
Obviously, you should avoid them too.
I will.
Anyways, I can't thank you enough for rescuing my sister, Savior.
Just call me Nico.
Oh gosh, would it not be rude to call you by name?
Huh? Why would it be? I mean, I'm just a kid like you guys.
Oh, then... would you like to visit our house, Nico?
Yes. Yay! Let's go!
Oh, shoot! Looks like we can't get past that block.
Seriously?
Oh my god! This game...
I'll be up ahead. I have literally never thought of that.
You get kinda used to all the debris after living here for a while. Come on, our house isn't far from here. Yep. That's the kind of game this is, Ryan. Welcome to OneShot.
So, welcome to our home.
I know it's not much, but feel free to make yourself comfortable.
Oh, there it is. Here, we want you to have this.
Glowy feather.
Oh, a feather! Edges are glowing yellow.
The sacred feather from the great prophet.
This old lady our dad used to know. Her feathers can glow in the dark and she can see into the future.
What?
Or something like that.
She gave one of her feathers to Father before she died. Father wanted to pass this down as an heirloom, although it feels more fitting for you to have it.
Are you sure?
Totally sure.
Totally sure.
I think that's what Father would have wanted.
Thank you.
There's a clover symbol on the cover of this book.
Hey! Just like... oh, my book!
Gosh, I still need to finish studying it.
Oh?
My friend gave it to me for Solstice Day. He's the one who wrote it, actually. He's also the one who taught me how to read.
Ooh!
I have a few more of his books somewhere.
Ooh! It's a plush toy! That's mine! Our friend gave it to me last year.
Oh?
Yeah, he has a fox too, and she can even talk.
What?
I know, I thought she was the coolest thing ever! So he got me a fox plush for Solstice Day.
Oh, that's nice of him.
He He's the best. Over here, we can see something else. Hey! So he went into the courtyard, so he thought I'd tag along. Same. Looks like it used to lead somewhere. Yeah, the secret grounds. It's been a while since we went there.
We don't have a way of getting there now, remember? There isn't a boat and none of us can swim, and what's the secret grounds? It's where our people are buried.
Sometimes we go there to visit Mom.
Well, her grave, anyway. Oh. Okay, Ryan.
Wait, how did you get there?
I thought you said there isn't a boat?
Oh, our friend helps us.
He has some sort of machine that allows him to fly.
Sometimes he takes us along.
But, like I was about to say, we haven't seen him around for a while.
I wonder when he'll come back. I wish we could go see Mom again.
Come on, Alula. Let's go back to the courtyard now.
Okay. Are you leaving now? Good luck, Nico! We believe in you.
Believe in Nico.
Oh, are you leaving now?
It was nice to meet you.
Really.
Thanks for everything.
Oh yeah, we can use the feather as a pen. I saw it in a picture book once. I found a pen, sort of.
Indeed you do. But are you not forgetting something?
Oh, the sun.
Oops, we forgot the sun.
Left it behind.
We can go to the refuge, though, we have to let Nico nap for, like, 5 seconds.
I'm a little tired from walking. Is it alright if I take a nap?
Nap time over. I'm back.
Madison, I had another dream. Did you see this one too?
Yeah.
Welcome back, Ryan.
It was in a big field, like the one in my last dream.
And Nico's a player character.
And I saw my village. But then I woke up. Oh, I don't think this world has anything like that. I mean, big wheat fields. The only big plants I've seen here are a bunch of weird trees. And those balls of moss floating in the water. Wait, is moss even a plant? Say, have you seen a wheat field before, Madison?
Yep.
Oh.
Banned. You are banned, Ryan. Ban Ryan. Just ban him.
They're really pretty, aren't they? The one around my village goes around for miles. The plants are really tall. Sometimes I can't even see through them. When it's windy out, the wind can make waves in it. It's like an ocean. A food. Oh, wait, but there's food in regular oceans, too.
You're banned, Ryan! Ryan!
Like fish or crabs. I've never actually been to real ocean before. Until now, actually.
I've been to the ocean.
That's really cool, Madison. I've only seen the ocean on TV before.
Ryan! Ryan, you know I won't ban you, but no.
What?
Let this poor cat child be.
I never thought I'd get to ride a boat to run. The water back home doesn't have glowy stuff like how it is here either. I guess it's because the world's already so dark. You know, I used to be scared of the dark, Madison. It's a little hard to imagine that now after spending so much time here. But not long ago, I couldn't even go to sleep that alone. Me too. Really? Even though you're a god?
Nico.
Yep. I see. Oh, but it's a good thing that I got over that fear. Otherwise, I wouldn't last long here. Then again, I've been carrying around the sun, so it's not too bad. Also, I don't feel scared at all with you guiding me.
Oh, no! Why is Nico so cute?
So?
He's... No! The face!
He is doing a cat emoticon face. So, thanks for that. Anyway, maybe we should head out now, Madison. He did the nya face. I love this child.
I'm adopting him.
I found a pen. Sort of.
Good. Please write your name here.
Yes! That's the exact thing.
Good luck.
Why are you so cute, Nico?
It's just a quick walk over to the refuge. Say goodbye to the glen, cause we're not gonna see it again.
Oh my!
What in the world?
Oh my god! Oh my god, Ryan. Fun fact, this track is called On Little Cat Feet. Kidding. Ah, the sun. Hello, Messiah. Welcome to the refuge. You understand what you must do here.
I'm supposed to go inside the tower, right?
Oh, Lord.
I already see the tower, so I guess we must be close. Where's the entrance?
On the surface.
The surface.
Look down, small one.
Ooh, we're pretty high up. I guess I gotta get down a lot of stairs. Or find an elevator.
Correct. However, the tower is a sacred place. Finding the entrance may be easy, but that alone will not be enough.
What do you mean?
Once you reach the surface, I recommend visiting the library for queens.
Alright. Thank you.
Off you go then. I wish you luck.
Okay. Come on! Work already! Huh? What was that? Come on!
Too busy for this.
Excuse me.
Whoa! You're... you!
Jeez, I didn't think I was gonna run into. This is embarrassing.
Is there anything I can help you with?
Yes, please. I'd like to know how to get to the surface.
Yeah, I was afraid you were going to say that.
Right now, this elevator is the only way to access the surface.
But... yeah, just take a look at it. Yeah. His name is Plight, or Lamplighter.
Looks like an elevator.
Well, you're not wrong, but...
go look at the button panel. Huh? There aren't any buttons.
Yep, that's a problem. There's usually a big button here that says ground on it. You know, because it takes you to the ground area. Now it's been ripped out? Or something? I try looking everywhere to it to no avail. Maybe it exploded.
You think we'll have to make a new one?
What? How?
We'll figure it out.
Oh. Let's just have Nico nap here quick, then we can... stuff. Okay, you've napped enough, Nico. Wake up.
Nico.
Pancakes.
No, what a happy little cat.
Patterson, I had another dream. Mama was there. Did you see her?
Yes.
She made me pancakes. I think it was my birthday. Because people always get their favorite food on their birthday. A whole lot of it. Do you have a birthday too?
Yep.
Oh, then what's your favorite food?
Is it pancakes?
Wait, do you like pancakes?
Of course I like pancakes.
Me too! On my last birthday, I ate 10 of them. I was so full I didn't eat anything else that day. My mama makes the best pancakes. And some of the neighbors make really good noodles. And oh, one of our neighbors make a lot of bread. Do you have any neighbors?
Yep.
Oh, do they share their food with you?
No.
That's not very nice of them. My neighbors and my mama take turns making food for the whole village each day. Everyone also takes turns doing chores and watching the little kids. I don't need to be watched anymore. I'm old enough to help out. I'm so...
oh, that's so cute.
I miss everyone. I've been gone for a while now, haven't I? I wonder if they're worried about me. Oh, speaking of helping out, we should probably go now. And over here is...
Ryan.
Over here is some apartments we can visit.
Shut up, Ryan. Shut up.
Here is a thing we need, locked. Not here.
Small potted plant. There's a pair of scissors on the ground. On a pile of hair? I don't think anyone's using it anymore, so... Take the scissors and run. What do you have to say? Okay. I'm trying to remember where this stuff is. Oh yeah, here we go. I need these. This fridge has magnets on it. Maybe they'll come in handy? I hope nobody will mind us taking them. Looks like I can lock this door. There might have been something else we need. Run, child, run. There's a...
Ram.
You just moved here from the Glen. Things are so different in the city. You've been to the Glen, right? Yeah. It seems so green back there. I really miss it. My neighbor gave me some plants to cheer up, but... I should probably get a muzzle for Betsy there. It's a Roomba! I'm not sure what this is. It's like a little car.
You should ride on it!
What? Do it!
You can ride on the Roomba! God, I love this game!
Game of the year! Let's you ride a Roomba!
That was fun.
Ryan, I could ride on a Roomba!
I love this small cat child. And,
I believe the thing we need to get is... here.
It's an empty coffee tin.
Oh, hi there.
Hello. How come there aren't anyone here? Normally, cafes have tons of people.
Yeah, it's a really slow day.
I think it's because the ground access elevator is broken.
So I've been told.
The city's infrastructure has been suffering a lot.
Sidewalks and stairs breaking off left and right. Now the only reliable way of transport are those elevators. Until now, anyway.
You know, the tall guy came in here earlier saying the same thing.
He asked me if I've seen a bun that says ground on it. He looked pretty stressed, so I wanted to cheer him up. I told him the only ground I've seen today is coffee grounds. He didn't get it. We can go back to the elevator deck. Oh, maybe we can make a button out of this. I can cut out a piece of can and fold it into a rectangle shape. Just like arts and crafts. I don't think it's supposed to be this simple. How are we going to connect it to the elevator? Well, let's find out. Magnets. Magnets don't stick to the aluminum, but... Oh, what if I just folded the magnets under the sedge? It's holding together, just barely. I hope that's good enough. Magnetized button. Let's hope this works. The button fits snugly and... I think I hear the machine powering on. Button completely fell apart.
Hey, you tried.
Oh no! Oh no.
If you go to your inventory, you tried. It's the thought that counts.
Tape dispenser. Oh, I could hold it together with the tape. I should have done this in the first place.
Over here.
We're going to need this soon. Take this film and expose it to the void. The answer will be revealed when you bring it back. Computer printed out a strange transparent sheet. And we have got the weird film. Before we do that, heavy piece of metal sent to the wall. I think it might be a door or some kind of vault. There's a small screen here in the middle.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Wow. I've actually never been to a big city before.
Ryan, no! Ryan!
All these lights, all these people. I guess most of this world's population lives here.
Doing, child. No, I don't know if it's a dire cutscene.
Let's hope this works.
Reactivating elevator services. Please input security code to continue. What?
That's never happened before. The squares?
Huh?
You saw them, right? They were on the door and...
Oh, nah. Square stuff happens all the time.
I meant the whole security code thing. But then again, the elevator hasn't been this broken before. Guess we should go look for our code, Madison. This next puzzle, the weird film. You guys aren't going to see it because of how OBS captures, but if I move this window off the screen... Our code is 63014. What? It works. I don't know what it did, but it actually works. Good job, kid. You're a genius. You know that?
Well, I had help from Madison, too.
Oh, right. The whole Messiah business. Anyway, ready to go? I'll be up ahead.
Well, are we ready to leave, Madison?
Yep.
We're ready.
All right, not then. Sure is taking a while. Gracious, I'm stuck in an elevator with the Maasai, and also literally God himself, this is awkward.
Oh, maybe we can chat to pass the time then?
You heard me? I mean,
sure.
Alright, Madison. Should I
ask about his job?
So, what do you do at your job?
You seem really busy. I fix lights, mostly. But now I also deliver and refill high-energy phosphor to structures that need them.
High-energy?
You know, the super-concentrated glowy stuff that they had to process in factories. It's what powers most of the city stuff.
Ooh!
We used to have a small army of delivery robots doing that, but lately a bunch of them have been breaking down, so until they fix them, I'll just have more work on my plate. I haven't slept in so long, and all the robots get fixed. No idea. It's all up to the scientists over at the labs. But they seem really concerned about something else lately.
Oh?
Never a good sign when even the smart folks are worried.
Alright, Madison, should I? This city is very big.
It's smaller than it looks. Getting pretty crowded, too. First there were the refugees from the Barrens, and now more Glen folks are moving in, too.
Oh? It's just safer here, you know?
I mean, it's not a haven by any means. That square stuff we just saw? We get more of that here than anywhere else, apparently.
I noticed.
We're lucky it only seems to affect the city's infrastructure. Landmass itself is still holding up.
Which is good, since there isn't much solid land here in the first place.
Library.
Can you tell me about the library? I'm supposed to go there.
Oh yeah, that's one of my main delivery spots. Those reading lights are pretty high maintenance, but I always feel out of place surrounded by smart people. Well, I guess you're pretty smart yourself, so you'll fit in fine. You and Madison. Anyway, it was nice meeting you,
Nico.
Right. See you around, kid. Gotta run now.
There you go. He seems in a hurry. I guess we should hurry too, Madison. People are counting on us. Let's go find that library.
Getting close to the end of the game. Whoa.
Did you see what happened?
Yeah?
My vision went blank for a second. Then I saw something?
Yes, Ryan?
I
you have a really short dream. Maybe. I wonder what that was about. Maybe if we go somewhere around. The fox! There's the fox. No, don't be shy. Come back, I just want to pet you. Whoa, Madison. No, I did. Ryan, I can't say if it is or not. I'll say it on the Discord. Madison, did you see that fox just now? It just ran behind the tree. I'm sorry if you were looking for me. But I cannot talk to you. Not now. But can you promise me something? Huh? If you can find a way to return, please do. What do you mean by that? No reply. Gone. Anyways, like somewhere around here is... That's not what I'm looking for. One second while I try to find this one place. Oh, there's also where we need to go. There's some big plastic discs in here. Looks like they're supposed to go in something. Hey, Madison, are we really gonna take these with us? They look so heavy. Alright. Hey, they're actually pretty light. This is an optional scene I'm about to do, but it's still hilarious. I herded rams and all I got was this lousy t-shirt. I see you have the club uniform. You may come in. It's the ram guy! The secret ram club. And it's our dear friend. It's good to see you too. So, meet again. Hello. Wait, aren't you from the village? Yes, but the rams are ever present. In the village, in the city, even in your heart. Okay. I'm a little sheepish, so let's leave. Yes, the secret ram club. Now we gotta race through here. It's our lamp friend. Oh, hey there. You, doing okay? Yep. What are you doing? Just filling this lamp here. It's taking a while. I think it might be leaking. Take off this shirt, Nico. Are you here for your photos? No? Alrighty then. I'll just, stand here. Where's the... You're supposed to put these lens in a certain order. Thanks. Okay. Yeah, that's what I... Okay, there's a place you can go and...
Back alley. Back here.
Enter and play with note attached. This is admittedly the more frustrating part of the game, because it kind of just is. I can't save and quit until I find another bed. Then it'll be time for the finale of the game. Okay, but... I'm so sorry, this is a very frustrating part of the game. I don't like this. Okay, 1 second. Enjoy the music. Guess that wasn't the right order.
At least tell me what I'm getting right and what I'm not getting right. Okay, found it. Found the stupid solution. That's what I did, Ryan. Step 2, G38. Thick, concave, thin, convex. There! Oh my god, that was stupid.
Cheese?
Ouch. Now I have a photo of me, though. I'll need this for later.
It's a photo of me! Are my eyes always this big?
That was so stupid, I'm so sorry. I'm going to edit that out somehow. I wonder what this could be. Okay, fair enough, Ryan. This is not the library. Hi. Evening news, evening news. Are you here to purchase a copy? No. Newspapers are for grown-ups. Grown-ups?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means people who aren't kids.
Kids? Aren't you a kid? Or a squid? I am a robot.
Right.
Fun fact.
It's a library. Yes, what? Brian, what? Excuse me.
Oh, you are the Messiah.
Welcome. When I first entered the city, a big robot told me to look for a library on the surface. This is the same library, right?
Affirmative.
Oh, goody. Well, we're here. What do we do now?
The big robot only said there'd be clues here. That is a question for the head librarian, George. Allow me to call her.
Decord.
She is not picking up.
Is she not here?
She is here. She is in the archival room upstairs. She is concentrating on her work. She will ignore any and all phone calls. For several days.
Yikes! Can you go get her in person then?
Leading this post is not my programming.
Then can I go myself?
Of course. The archival room is accessible through the stairwell behind me.
Gotcha, thanks.
You won't actually let us through. You have to find another way in. Which is why we had her picture taken.
Understood.
Hey, are you guys ready for another puzzle that's stupid?
In order to gain further access to the labs, you must pass the security system test. You must change the color of the lights into a specific configuration. Allow me.
Oh boy, my favorite.
Toe to tip, just like Undertale. Take it to the bank, boys. This one's just like Undertale. One light correct. Two lights correct.
Okay, the purple.
Our blue hits blue. And...
Three lights correct. Oh God.
Yes! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Yes, I hate that puzzle.
It's randomized every time you play this game.
And it's dumb.
Well?
Oh shoot! If I had known you'd be here so soon, I would have turned off the system.
Hello there. Sorry about the weird security measures.
It's okay. Madison helped me solve it.
Did they now? So, I help you with anything?
Yeah, where's the library?
Library? That's all the way on the other side of town.
Fastest route is where you take the shortcut through the back alley, but...
I think that's how we got here, actually.
Oh, good.
You should head back to that direction, walk to the east a bit.
You'll find it eventually.
Okay, thank you.
Something is poking out from the shelf.
Ryan.
I need to get her ID card, so...
Once we get to the library and stuff, I'm calling the police.
Isn't that kind of familiar?
Yeah, that lady built the one robot back in the Barrens, I believe.
I can't fast travel.
So we have to go back to the library and
that phone call to happen again.
Since I didn't think we could do...
Unauthorized entry. Library card required for further access. Wait, what?
Library card required for further access.
I don't have a library card, though.
George can get one, but she isn't answering.
She's literally just up the staircase, and he can't go get her.
Tomorrow night I'll try to finish this, I promise.
She is not picking up. I figured. Are you sure you can't just let me through? Letting you through without a library card is against my programming.
What? Even an emergency? My programming is not flexible. I have not been tethered. Ugh. Back to the factory. Oh, hey, you're back. Can I help you with anything else? Yeah. Do you know how I can get a library card?
A library card?
You'll have to ask the library for that. I tried. I needed to see the head librarian. I can't get to see her without a library card. At the same time, she's the one who gives out library cards.
Ryan?
Ryan. Shut up. God.
Really?
That sounds like George, alright.
I'm sorry you caught her on a bad day. Wait, I know. I can just give you my library card. It won't be hard for me to get another one. Oh, thanks.
There. You're all set, I think.
Wait. Shoot. I forgot. The front desk library bots have facial recognition. Yeah, my photo on the card won't match you.
Unless I tape a photo of my face to your card.
Card face.
I'm tired.
That was a joke. Who knows, maybe we'll get lucky and the robot will take it anyway.
Worst comes worse, you can always find somewhere to take a photo.
How did you get this? This robot lady in the Barrens gave it to me. She looked kinda like you.
I see.
It was supposed to be such a breakthrough, you know? I even based her on myself so I know it works.
Breakthrough?
We wanted to build a robot that acts like a person. Thinks like a person. A robot that isn't bound by its own code. Oh! But turns out you can't really build something like that. Too many contradictions in the code made her unstable. That was the only time I've ever seen a robot go rogue. Scariest day of my life, I'll tell you what. Rogue? But she seemed so nice when we talked. Even if she talked a little weird. She's been repaired for some time now. My friend was able to stabilize her volatile state through his own means. Real miracle worker, that. After he was through, she ended up turning out just like how I wanted. The damage was already done. I gave up on her back then. We all did. I'm sure she realized that, and now she won't ever come back. She won't even answer my letters. I'm sorry. Sorry for rambling. You should hold on to that amber, okay? I will.
Forgot the card.
Come on. Photo match successful. You're good to go. Have a nice day, Miss Kip. Maybe I should have changed the name. Now we get to see George. Someone here to see the brilliant George, eh? Got one of my genius and couldn't help but come see for yourself, huh? Don't answer. Of course you are. What else could you possibly want? Actually, I need your help. Can you tell me what I need to do? I think I'm supposed to go in the tower. But of course I can help. For I, the brilliant and intelligent head librarian George, beholder of all knowledge.
I believe you're supposed to go in the tower.
That's what I said. But how, exactly?
Through the tower entrance room.
Alas, going beyond that small entrance room requires ancient, forbidden knowledge that eludes even George.
But fear not. That knowledge happens to be recorded in some cryptic tome in a London language.
Yep, dice.
And I know that I, George, am fluent in several dead languages.
I see.
Get back here.
Oh! I do have this book, though. I think it's written in some sort of words I don't recognize.
Okay, Nox.
Uh-huh. An ancient book. Written by no less than the most ancient... Wait a minute. This isn't ancient at all. But it's written in a dead language nevertheless. It's time for me to unleash my brilliance. For George, me, possessor of at least one PhD, it's Ninja Brian, shall translate this. This will take some time, however. I see. Ooh. Excuse me. Oh, what's this? You're sleepy? A little.
You're not, because I have read a book on hospitality before, and thus have prepared for this exact situation. Guest rooms in the attic down the hall.
You know, I think we could actually finish this tonight. That game isn't too long, it's just I'm worried about doing it all in one go. What is it, Ryan?
No! You stop!
There are six. Which one did you encounter?
There are six different versions of George, and it's randomized every time you play one shot. So yeah.
I'm a little tired
now. Screw it. Let's do the rest tonight.
Madison? I guess you saw my dream?
Yes.
It was... Come on. Let's go. I've done it! I have finished the daunting task of translating this journal. Oh, that was fast. But of course, I am the speediest translator in recent history. Anyway, I made you a line-by-line transcript. It looks like this journal might be meant for Madison. Welcome back, Nox. Huh? Here, take a look yourself.
Yeah, you should stop watching at this point, Ryan, if you want to be surprised by the rest of the story. This is a wonderful game, and you should definitely experience Standing Blind. So, stay if you want, but you will be spoiled on in-game stuff. So, watch at your own risk. I'm gonna keep going anyways because scream and all, but... Oh, yes, good. Greetings, Madison. You can finally read this. That means you are near the tower.
The tower is... Later, Ryan.
The tower is the domain of an elusive entity. This being is connected to the world. For now, you can think of it as the spirit of the world. It has no physical form, but it can communicate through computers and other machinery. You know who I am talking about, of course. When you first arrived here with our savior, no doubt contacted you right away. Through its own means, the entity will guide both of you to the tower. The entry room is at the tower's base. Not only do you need the sun there, but also three pieces of the previous sun. The savior will not be able to do anything there. You, Madison, on the other hand. Look at the pattern on the floor. Do as it says. The window will be gone, so you need to bring it back. There, that's the last of it. The rest of the pages are torn out. You didn't do this, did you?
No.
A shame. I was wondering what window was supposed to mean. Oh well, I guess Madison will have to figure out that one. Right. By the way, what does it mean by three pieces of the previous sun? I only have this sun. Aha. That is a question George can answer. One second. It means you need items containing yellow phosphor, the rarest of the phosphors. Said to absorb sunlight for the longest time and never fade out. Oh, I do have a piece of amber and feather. They're both glowing yellow. But alas, you are missing the third, no? They're not, for George, the collector of rare artifacts, will assist you. Here.
It's a dye.
Oh, it looks like you?
Yes.
No, you'll never forget my face.
The face of knowledge.
Oh, thank you. Good luck on your journey, small child. George shall bid you farewell now. Almost there to the endgame. Hey, Madison? Do you remember where the cafe is?
Yep.
Oh, good. I'm asking because, well, I'm a little hungry. Actually, I'm really hungry. I haven't eaten anything since I got here. So, is it okay if we go get some food before we enter the tower? I hope they have pancakes. This scene is optional, but it's only optional if you're a heartless monster. Like, do not deny Nico his pancakes. Go back to the cafe and give him his pancakes. Exactly, Knox, you get me. Oh, hey, you're back. Did you manage to fix the elevator?
Mm-hmm.
Madison and I went to the surface already, and... Well, I remembered there being a cafe here. You have pancakes?
You sure do.
Wait, I don't have any money. Maybe I can help you wash dishes or something?
No, it's on the house. Least I can do for the savior, right? Here, why don't you take a seat?
I'll go fry up some free pancakes. He can have his pancakes. These pancakes are so good. Thank you so much.
No problem.
You look really hungry. Yeah. I thought this would be my last chance to eat something before I go in the tower.
Ah, gotcha.
So, I guess pancakes are your favorite food?
Mm-hmm.
Well, almost. My favorite food in the world are the special pancakes that my mama makes. She likes to pick hazelnuts and grind them up in the batter.
Oh, wow, that sounds amazing.
They taste amazing. She always made them when I was feeling sad. Or lonely. Or... Mama. I really miss her.
weird feeling all of a sudden. Am I even here to save the world? People have been saying how the sun won't fix anything. I don't even know why I'm here. I just want to see my mama again. Oh, there. It's gonna be okay. And I'm sure you'll be able to save the world. You're a tough kid. You managed to get this far already, right? Yeah, but... And you'll get to go home afterwards, right? Right. Hey, want some more pancakes? It's okay. I'll be fine. So, yeah. Thanks for coming by. Thanks for listening. And for the pancakes. No problem. Good luck. Poor Nico. He's a child. Needs elevator stuck. Okay, now we can go. That was too precious. This is gonna start the endgame, which is gonna give us a lot of spoilers for OneShot. What? That was... Okay, there we go.
Nico. This inside of the tower? A lot darker than I thought. Wait, where's the sun? Madison, do you know what happened to the sun? Madison? Come on, Madison. Say something. Madison!
Hello, Nico. Hello. Congratulations. You are now inside the tower. Are you talking to me now?
Correct.
But you were always talking to Madison before. Where's...
Madison has already left.
I had Tresor to contact you directly. Wait, so Madison is gone? Just like that?
Correct.
For good?
Correct.
Madison has already finished their mission. So have you, Nico.
Here, you can rest now.
Everything that's happened here is like a bad dream. When you wake up, you will be home. Oh,
But
what's wrong?
I thought there would be more to it, you know? I thought we were supposed to go to the top of the tower. I thought there was supposed to be somewhere we need to put the sun in. You know? I don't even have the sun anymore. Madison is just gone. This feels wrong.
But you did good. You saved the world, Nico. Are you not happy?
I guess I am. But it's just... Never even got to say goodbye to Madison.
As for you, Madison, we're done here. Please don't return to this world anymore.
We're not completely done yet, though. One second. I just need to find the right file. Then we can go back and save. Go.
Second, if I can just move this to this.
Nico.
I'm gonna have to switch to monitor capture for this, because this next part is going to be wild.
Hello? Madison? Was that you just now? I thought I heard your voice. In my dream. Guess not. Wait, there's something in my pocket. I don't remember putting it there.
A black clover.
You're still here? Nico, why are you still here? You! Why did you come back, Madison? I told you to stay away. You knew I tried to cut the story short. Is that it? You want more out of me. Is that it? Fine. If you don't want to leave, I'll make sure you never do.
Back then, I told you about the entity as little as possible. Apologies for that. I did not want to put the librarian in danger. This being has a habit of silencing the people who learn of its true nature. Regrettably, I have seen it happen to dear friends. But do not worry. The entity cannot touch you. Nor can it do anything to me. I already left the world on my own terms. I never meant for the entity to exist. But now that it is fully sentient, one thing became clear. The entity seeks death. Death to itself, death to the world, a relentless desire that manifested physically. I've already seen the scars. From
Right now, the entity is doing everything it can to impede your progress, stalling for even a few minutes. Before you inevitably bring the sun to its tower summit. That is where you, God, will make the final judgment for the world. Of course, the entity will contact you again there. When it does, it will trick you into shattering the sun. This will end the world instantly. No, it is not that simple. I am sorry. I do not know what to do in a situation like this. But I think I have to tell you the truth. The sun is the Messiah's tie to the world. As long as the sun is intact, the Messiah remains trapped here. Shattering the sun may terminate this world, but it is also the only way for the Messiah to return home. I did not realize things could end up like this. Please forgive me. It's the light bulb. Thank goodness it's safe. I guess Madison isn't coming back. Ego. I'm here. Madison? Yeah? Is that really you? I thought you were gone. I never left you. Oh, I was feeling a bit scared back there. I thought I was completely alone. That was silly of me to assume, wasn't it? I guess we need to figure out where to go now and... The sun! It lit up on its own! Guess I should pick it up, right, Madison? place from the start of the game. So, you actually made it here. I guess you win, Madison. I'll tell you how to save the world, then. When you reach the summit, shatter the light bulb and... I'm just humoring you. I know you've been getting help from a certain someone. He already told you about the choice, didn't he? Are you still planning to save the world, Madison? Why are you trying so hard for this? Haven't you even figured out what this world is? I told you at the beginning, your mission is to help Nico leave. Because Nico isn't part of this world. Nico is the only thing worth saving here. That's not true. The final choice is up to you. I can't go against my programming. You only have one shot, Madison. If you choose to smash a light bulb, then Nico wakes up back home, like it was all a dream. If you let Nico return the sun, the child will have to bear the weight of his sacrifice. At least tell Nico the truth. You do care about Nico, don't you? Sure is taking a while. I guess this elevator leads to the top of the tower, Madison. Are you excited, Madison? We're finally gonna save the world! And I know it's for real this time, because you were here. And then, I'll get to go home for real this time, too! I can't wait to see everyone again. Are you okay, Madison? Seem a little quiet.
Nico.
Yeah?
I need to tell you something.
I'm listening.
We can't save both. The world and you.
That's supposed to mean, Madison. To send you home, you must break the light bulb. What? Won't that end the world? I don't want that to happen. So, what happens when we save the world? What happens to me? I don't know. You don't?
I can't do this to Nico.
Happy, Nico? Excited?
Let me free.
This is where the sun belongs. If I put the sun here, I'll be able to save the world, right? But if I want to go home, I have to break it? Oh. Madison, what should I do? It's the right thing to do.
You deserve to go home, Nico. You really do.
I trust your judgment, Madison. Madison? What happened? It's very dark in here. Oh, I can see a light at the end of this passage. I think I hear a voice, too. Mama? I can hear her calling me. All I need to do is pass through this wall. I'll finally be home again. Madison, I guess this is goodbye. Thank you for everything.
At least he's home. At least I could save someone. This game ruined me emotionally just as bad as Undertale did. Please play OneShot. Please. It is such a good game. Thanks for playing. Fatal error. Savior not found. Shutting down.